Hey Internet, it's Colorful Artie and welcome to the last episode of Putt Putt and Pep's Balloon-O-Rama. 110 levels down, only 10 left. And it's time for the final world. And it's an interesting one. It's the bonus world.
Hot ziggity, is this ever going to be fun?
Putt Putt is returning to the moon one last time so he can finish popping all his balloons. Apparently he felt incredibly guilty about his balloons going all the way into outer space. Oh, bother. This is gonna be a thing. I'd say on average, at least if memory serves, this world's a bit more forgiving than the last one. But it does hold the hardest level in the game, so there is that. Still, I like how there's not anti-gravity unless you have the space helmet. Also, I am amazed that in outer space, Putt Putt's balloons have held their helium. This means we're probably going to hear the music a lot more. Like, the full music loop. Oh no, I can't believe it. It's a beautiful space world. Putt Putt, you have returned to the moon one last time so you can pop all these balloons. Yeah, this level, I'd say, like, the worlds are longer than they were in the UFO version, but they're much more fair and fun. Because they don't spam bumpers and spinners everywhere. After that world, a single level without any bumpers, paint buckets, or spinners is a breath of fresh air. Even if the balloons do regenerate all the time. Humongous Entertainment. Beautiful graphics, catchy music, and often very fun gameplay. The other junior arcade games I'm planning on Let's Playing are all more fun than this one. And less boring. There are also games that where the custom level editor is very, very fun to use. Balloon-O-Rama's is like, good? But I mean, Balloon-O-Rama, you can only do so much with the custom level editor. Come on. Ah, Pep! That last balloon is always such a pain. But we did it! Putt, putt, putt! Alright! What's the mystery balloon? It's the magnet boots! Excellent. Thought I would get more candy than that. Garbage? No. Now Putt Putt's gonna have to get vacuumed out. I just realized, the magnet boots, did Pep steal those from Lemmings too? This might be a level where the balloons just infinitely spawn and you need to be fast. I swear I've popped these balloons on the bottom, like, far more times than once. Could just be me, though. Boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom.
What determines how high he gets launched? In an effort to avoid the garbage, Putt Putt accidentally picked all the garbage up. Don't you hate it when that happens? Yeah, these balloons just seem to infinitely spawn. I don't like that. Well, at least now I can get launched up to the ceiling easily. Magna Boots are not very good at launching Pep up to the ceiling. Aw, I didn't get the sun. Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun. That's a song by the hit, popular heavy metal singer, Raffi. Look him up. Well, maybe not heavy metal, but he's pretty boss. Stop appearing, balloons! I've popped you, just stay popped. As Charlie Brown would say, good grief. Nope. Thank goodness. Okay, these levels are like 10 times longer than they should be. Oh, great. Not the spinners. Three cheers for confetti. I will gladly pick up garbage for the sake of confetti. And Pep's life, you know. I'm sure like half the stuff I say in this Let's Play that took out of context would sound really weird. Then again, I guess that's kind of Let's Playing in general. Wowee! Let's just pop him already. This Let's Play's gone on long enough, I think. Humongous Entertainment Let's Plays should only be so long. This is, like, gonna be longer than my Spy Fox Let's Play, and I showed off everything in that game. Then again, I'm also showing off everything in this game. Most people would not play to the end. Colorful Arty is not most people. What are you looking at, you hockey puck? Pop, pop. Oh, I hate infinitely spawning well, not hate. I do not like infinitely spawning eyeballs. What is this? One eyeball is enough, okay? Oh, darn it. At least these are only single balloons. Boom, 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 boom. Whoa, that was a close one. At least Pep still has two lives. If Pep has two lives, I'm comfortable. If he only has one, that's when I start worrying. Because one mistake caused me to have to do the whole course again. So I'd like to think that the eyeballs have stopped spawning, but no, of course! I had to say it. I had to say it. Barring anything stupid, only one red balloon left. Not even at the halfway mark. Oh, why? We had enough of this in the UFO, thank you. Not Sonic the Hedgehog Casino Zone. Please stop bumping me around. Putt Putt and your stupid frontal collision detection that doesn't work.
Balloon-O-Rama is fun for the first 5 or 6 worlds. Honestly, after Fedigar's house, it's really not worth playing more. Unless you want to try the Humongous Carnival, but... honestly, they totally could have made it into the Humongous Carnival, and I'd be cool with that. Or end up level 101, like I thought I ended up as a kid. You really didn't want me to get that white balloon. Thank you. Now I hate to ask more of you, but if you could hit one of those balloons up there while we have a pin bucket, that would be lovely, I appreciate it. Physics! Or lack thereof. Yeah, wait. Did the designers actually bother beating all the levels? Because if so, I'm pretty sure they would make some changes. Oh, come on! I totally hit that balloon holding up the pin bucket. They seriously exist just to troll you, dude. No, we're not sending you that way. We're sending you completely the opposite way. At least the bumpers are predictable. Seriously, by the time you have to just launch Pep up in the air and pray with all your heart that it pops the balloon, you're doing something wrong with the level design. Seriously, the only strategy for this level to pop one of those pin balloons is to pray. Because the spinners just sometimes do not work. Actually, no, I need to rephrase that. The spinners 90% of the time do not work. Get a 10% hit rate. If I was 25 Rumble, I would not take that odds. Thank you! It only took me like 100 tries. Now we get to do the exact same thing on the other side.
Okay, remember when I said the moon was in much better world than the UFO? I take that back. They are pretty much identical in terms of quality. You forgot something over there, Pep. There we go. Also, I don't think there are any more bonus levels. Which makes sense, since we are on the bonus level planet. Okay, this level's also incredibly sadistic. It looks cool, but wow. Look at all those paint buckets we have to get rid of. I can't believe I got it that easily. Hey, we finally get to be blue! How come you can't paint Putt Putt black? Come on. Yep, thank you. Bounding Leap on this level is really not gonna cut it, I just realized. Invisible Strain. Because it blends in perfectly with the pitch black background. Roosh! Ugh. Don't you hate it when your Let's playing and then all of a sudden your ear starts really itching but you can't scratch it because you're wearing a headset? Yeah, that's happening to me right now. Come on! Party time! 4 levels left. This level seems to be like an art piece. And it's saying, did you know you can make art out of balloons? Now you do. This episode of Putt Putt and Pep's Balloon-O-Rama has been brought to you by Mr. T. I pity the fool who watched this Let's Play! Green clams can't stop me, nor can beach balls, nor eyeballs, nor paint buckets, nor spinners or bumpers. However, pigs with bowling balls, maybe. You know we haven't seen the last of the pigs with bowling balls. And kaboom! OxyClean! This has been Non Sequitur, the episode. Hope you enjoyed it! I can't think of what witty commentary to give, so I will just tell everybody I love potatoes. Also, I am getting pizza tonight for dinner. Pep. Even when the spinner is cooperating with you, it still doesn't cooperate with you. It'll either, like, knock Pep away from the balloons, or it'll launch him way too far towards the balloons, and he'll miss them anyways. Take that clam. Come on! Come on! Niche! Okay. Okay, that one balloon is in the most obnoxious spot, right next to a spinner, which will never knock it towards the... Yeah! Alright, now for the ultimate challenge. I'm going to attempt to play Balloon-O-Rama. One-handed, while texting my dad that I don't know if the pizza's been ordered with the other. Let's see how this goes. Well, that went terribly. Nope, I can't do that.
We can try this again later.
Or we could try it again now. We don't have to wait for the game over balloons to pop. Didn't we already have this level? Like, exactly? Yeah. And no, I don't want to be yellow, I want to be blue! Seriously, they gotta cool it with the paint buckets. As interesting as they are, if you just put a bunch of them in a row... Okay, what was that? I saw Pep fall right into Putt Putt's chassis and then hit the ground. I am slow-motioning that. Actually, I probably will forget by the time I edit this. If I remember, I will slow-motion that.
As interesting as they are, if you just put a bunch of them in a row... Okay, what was that?
Whoosh! Dad, I'm really sorry, but I cannot text you back right now. I'm playing Balloon-O-Rama for the public entertainment. No, it's not, like, super important. It's just about the pizza we're ordering for tonight. Actually, I guess that is pretty important. What color Putt Putt should we be? Oh, no white paint! Whoa, I didn't know the buckets popped balloons for you! That's actually really cool. Why don't they use that gimmick more? Instead of just like, look, it's a bucket! It's hard to pop, and it stuns you if it hits you. Isn't that great? No. It is absolutely not great. Also, if Putt Putt's a different color than purple, I wonder if that'll change the final cutscene's color. Green Putt Putt! Green Putt Putt is more environmentally conscious than the other Putt Putts. Red Putt Putt makes you more hungry than the other Putt Putts. Purple Putt Putt is the original. Orange Putt Putt is lame. Who would pick Orange Putt Putt? My apologies to anybody who really likes Orange Putt Putt, but he is probably my least favorite color Putt Putt. Come on, Pip! Jeez. How did you pop the balloon above the bucket, but not, like, the one that's holding the bucket? Okay, Pep was gonna have serious brain damage by the end of this let's play. Thank goodness! Come, Pep! Let's see if we can get Rover to help us for the last two levels. More with the paint buckets and spinners and bumpers! Blah, said Toad. The unofficial name for this level is Pray to God that You Will Live. Just kidding. Well, the spinners are being quite cooperative on this level. Had to say it. Come on, Pep. Come on. Why is this green? I don't want to be pink, Putt Putt. Pink is, like, literally my least favorite color. Give me candy, Pep! Thank you, Pep. Can the spinners please stop trolling me? They never do what I want them to, like, ever. Come on, level. Come on. Stop it! No, stop it. That is not what I said to do. Thank you. No thanks to you, spinners. The spinners do everything they can to try to kill you. Come on, come on, come on! Thank you! Alright, it's the final level of the game. And jeez Louise, it's probably the hardest level in the game. Because you have to go up straight for the center. And if you can't do it on the first try, guess what? You just lost the level, pretty much. There's seriously just no going up the sides. Come on. You can... And that can happen, yeah. That balloon's supposed to knock him up and hit the balloons holding up the paint buckets, but no, that doesn't happen about 75% of the time, I'd say. So if you're looking for ways to beat these levels easily, I'm sorry. The best I can say is keep trying and pray God is on your side. Oh, yay! Well, at least finish the game as Blue Putt Putt or Red Putt Putt. Oh, yay! I didn't even know that was possible, to be perfectly honest. I am completely convinced that the sadist who designed this did not test it out. I believe the designers of this game and the testers were a completely different set of people. I'm guessing the testers were like, seriously, there is no way this is a good idea for a kid's game. And people were like, oh, tough! We're not gonna reprogram it. Or not reprogram, but like, redesign it. And even once one of the paint buckets is gone, it's still insanely hard to get up the middle. It's just so narrow, and of course, you can game over extremely easy. On. Please, Pep. That is what I'm talking about. Cool. Curse you, bumpers. Curse you to the abyss. Getting those balloons in the middle of the bumpers is nigh-on impossible. Part of it. Oh wow, oh wow! He made it all the way through the bumper tunnel. Pep's got the skills! I don't know what that question mark balloon is, but I really hope it's the magnet booth. Or no, I really hope it's Super Pep. Because Super Pep can pass through the freaking bumpers. There's never a time where I'm not cool with Super Pep. Please. Don't move away from Pep. That's rude. Super Pep! Da-da-da-da! Yes. Super Pep!
Great job, Pep. Pep, you're the greatest balloon poppin' pup I know.
Nope.
Hooray!
Was that worth it, Pep? No, it wasn't! That's Balloon-O-Rama. Oh, man. Hey, Rhett Mathis? Alright, I am sorry for all my wanks in that episode. But, jeez, that... The last 20 levels just are not fun. Ooh, I love this song! But yeah, that's not quite the end of the Let's Play, because I still want to show off the custom level editor. I will not go super in-depth with that, though, so don't worry. Phew! This game is fun for the first 80 or 90 levels. And then it just becomes frustrating. But it's still a cool game, and it's got great graphics. It's got great music. So, I'd say good job, Humongous Entertainment. There are just some things that you need to fix, like test the levels more.
Do you want to play again?
No, I am done. Thanks for watching, I'm Colorful Arnie, and I hope to see you for the bonus episode. Have a great day, and God bless.